And we're gathered here to witness the second match from the best out of three played at the G-Star 2010 All-Star Invitational Tournament that was organized by Blizzard and GOM TV. It's going to be once again a face-off between here the Red Protoss oGsInCa, one of the most well-known Protoss players from Team Old Generation Starcrafters, and his opponent MakaPrime, member of Team Prime. There's not much to say about Maka anymore. I mean, most people know him. Terran player, start playing StarCraft 2 on the bait. I remember seeing some matches from him. He came from Warcraft 3, we played Warcraft 3 before, and well, he's one of the top Terrans in my modest opinion. And well, they're facing off here on the second match, like I mentioned. I'm gonna spoil it for whoever didn't watch the first match, so better go take a look at it before I spoil it for you. Mak is leading 1-0, he won the first match, and meaning that Inca has to do something about it on this match, because being a best out of three, if he doesn't, well, Maka will take the cake and will win the series. Apparently Maka is just checking this little corner. I guess he got some experiences with this little corner here. Maybe some proxy pylons there or something, but no, Inca didn't went for any of that, I guess. And Inca actually heading southeast, so he's not even heading the right way. It's gonna take him a little bit to actually go up there and check Maka's base. But like I was just mentioning, Mak is quite a good player, very experienced, been on the GSLs. Inca as well, shows their level of skill. And another thing I enjoyed on this replay, or at least I'm enjoying for now, is the fact that it's held at Shakura's Plateau. It's a map that I didn't get that many replays. I only occasionally get a couple of matches that are played here, so pretty cool stuff. This map is kinda interesting, I like it, because look at this main base, just fairly large. Lots of spots to make surprise drops without your opponent noticing, unless your opponent takes care of getting some motion detectors on the corners, something like proxy pylons all over the place, or on the Terran's player side. Maybe some buildings built more here close to the corners would be an idea. For now, he's just finishing his wall off, as you guys can see. And there's an interesting move. Maka going for both refineries, both gas, at the same time. He might be planning on some kind of intensive gas build. And I'm just trying to think about it. Maybe some Banshee play. Early Banshees would require some gas. Maybe that's going to be his idea, his plan. I guess we're going to see it pretty soon. For now, he's finished his wall off. Still doesn't have anything else working out of a single racks. And like I was mentioning, these edges are kind of dangerous. He needs to be aware of it. On the Protoss side, he needs to be aware of Medivac drops, obviously. And on the Terran side, maybe some well, Warp Prism drops are doable. Maybe some Blink Stalkers wandering around would be nasty as well, so there is some viable options to just harass your opponent, especially if he doesn't take care of the little corners and make sure that he's going to be able to detect. As you can see here, Maka even placing his factory far away from the base on this corner here. It's going to be another motion detector, and obviously it's going to be used for the purpose that he has the intention. Not sure if he's going to go for any kind of mech build, but for now, this a big amount of gas might indicate he's going to go for some Banshee play, I would say. Meanwhile, here on Inca's side, Gateway into Cybernetics Core, Chrono boosting some Stalkers out, not much going on. Another play that you see frequently on this map is just destroying these rocks here on the back of your base, and has this fairly straightforward rush into your opponent's base with another rock there. Fairly easy. If you mass up a nice group of units, you can destroy this fairly quickly and just go and pressure your opponent on the back of his base. It's quite useful because the rush distance on this map is not one of the shortest, it's fairly long, and it's a way of shorten the distance, just make it happen faster. Meanwhile, Inca going for a Nexus, picking up his natural expo, while on Maka's side, he's getting the starport, making the switch, so attaching the tech lab to the starport, we're gonna start seeing some Banshees coming out. Pretty sure of it, there it is, the first Banshee, and reinforcing with bunkers his main door. I think he's afraid of something for now. Even placing two bunkers here seems a bit over the top. But for now, everything just fine. They're just mackering, and the Inca is gonna try to establish his second base, probably to balance his income and keep the pace against the Terran player. One gateway, two, three gateways into Robo. So gonna be playing out of three gateways pretty soon. That robotics facility, probably to get some observers out to take a look at what Maka is planning to do. The first three stalkers coming into the ramp on the main door, instantly pushed back. There's nothing here for them to even watch. And the first banshee is finally out. So getting cloaking field as well in the second banshee. So I think that Maka is committed to the banshee play, at least for the early stages of the game. He might be preparing some kind of transition later on, especially because we already see more barracks getting established there, getting built. Also because he's getting a command center done. So planning on picking up his natural axle and not fall behind on the econ game. Let's see how the econ game is at the moment. Yeah, Inca pulling ahead. Two more racks, so three racks play pretty soon. What else is getting attached here? A reactor, so might be seeing plenty of marines soon enough. Meanwhile, incoming banshee all the way on the north side of the main base of Inca. I think he's gonna advance here. There it is, advancing with already the cloaking. Try to poke at those probes, but no, the observer was ready there, a defensive observer, backed up by several stalkers, and just push away this banshee with a single kill. So for now he's not paying off. A second banshee advanced, also cloaking, this time on the natural expo, trying to get some more kills. Might be more successful, but three kills, the observer showed up, and there's plenty of defenses around, and got killed, so that banshee got the big blow there. Another attempt by Maka, second wave, second assault on the natural, on the mineral line of the main base. Once again, didn't got very successful there. I guess he's gonna have to change his approach to this game, getting a third banshee out, and now stopping. Meanwhile, he's working out of three racks, two of them with tech labs, so we might be seeing a lot of marauders soon enough, just make his army marauder heavy. And he's getting already a third command center build while he didn't even establish his second base. Seems like he's committed to a big macro game here. I mean, he didn't even establish his second base, already the third one getting ready. I wonder if he's just getting a million SCVs so he can have enough to provide for both bases at the same time. Meanwhile, this one is still halfway done, so probably he's gonna plan on it later on. Army count, let's take a look at how the armies is at the moment. Okay, so for now Inca pulling ahead, 75 against 53. Once again the banshee trying to be annoying, killing another pro, but only two kills there. And Inca already has the robotics bay ready, so he's gonna start getting some colossi out, I would say. Let's see the unit composition. There's not much of an army on both sides, to be honest. 7 stalkers, 3 zealots, 3 sentries, 6 marines, 2 banshees, 3 marauders. Not much going on for now, at least on the armies. They have fairly small groups, probably trying to focus a lot on their macroing, but apparently now Inca transitioning and reinforcing his army with some colossi, getting already the extended thermal lance, and even taking a Stargate and getting the first Phoenix out. So kind of an interesting mix here on the army from Inca. A single Phoenix won't be able to do much, I would say, but if he keeps reinforcing, maybe he can at least immobilize some of the units from Maka's army, probably lift up some marauders and just hold them enough time to make a push. And apparently that's what Inca is planning at the moment, because as you can see here, there's several red dots streaming through that map, gonna start entering the main the natural expo from MakaPrime, just gathering all of them here. I'm not sure if he's waiting for the extended thermal lance to finish. No, he's gonna push shields up, both shields up from those sentries, focusing fire on that bunker. Bunker destroyed, nice force fields there, splitting Maka's army in two. And look at all of this on the back, they're actually not doing that much, while the zealots just slice and dice all the ones that got contained in the front of the force fields. Very nice play, and forcing Maka to GG out of this match. That split with the force fields were enough for this colossi to just melt away that line, backed up by all the stalkers, and Maka just noticed that he didn't have enough of an army. As you guys can see, he was just preparing the counter for that colossi. Look, the two Vikings coming out, so I guess he wasn't fast enough, and that time push by Inca had its effect, and Inca took this game. So tied 1-1 now. Let's see what happens on the next match, because the third one will be for good, and whoever takes that one will take the final win. See you guys later, okay? Have fun.